Hello, friends. So in 1993, June 1993, I published a book called Ageless Body, Timeless Mind, which became a huge bestseller because I was on the Oprah Winfrey Show. I felt at that time that even though the book became a huge bestseller, that people did not really understand the basic premise behind the book, Ageless Body, Timeless Mind, because the tenets presented in it were, in a sense, before the American and the Western public was familiar with non-duality and the wisdom traditions of Indian and Vedic philosophy. So I'd like to give you a very succinct and brief basis for the philosophical and scientific reasoning for ageless body, timeless mind. So as you know, right now there's a lot of interest in longevity, health span. People are talking about signal molecules, which is very reductionist, but apparently they are effective in animal models and maybe quite effective in humans. I look forward to it. There are also Ayurvedic adaptogens that are being spoken of, vagal stimulation, but nobody is speaking even today on how we metabolize the experience of time into the aging process. So as I've mentioned in previous videos, I think, in yogic traditions, there's a phrase, time is the consumer and we are its food. We are time's food. We metabolize every experience epigenetically that modifies gene activity, but we also metabolize the experience of time. And as I said, any experience, eating, breathing, digestion, metabolism, elimination, sensory experience, thoughts, feelings, emotions, desires, imagination, all trigger on-off switches in our epigenetic and histone framework, which turns genes on and off, sometimes in the direction of homeostasis, sometimes in the direction of inflammation. But now let's talk specifically about the metabolism of time. In the Vedic and non-dual traditions of Indian philosophy, a view of reality exists where matter is not seen as a separate independent entity, but rather as a manifestation of perceptual activity within consciousness itself. According to these traditions, the human body, including the brain, is not just a physical machine, but a complex field of awareness within the larger formless field of pure consciousness. Consciousness, the fundamental reality, and the material world, including the human body, is a modified form of this consciousness. From this perspective, the body and its processes, including homeostasis and the experience of time, are not separate from consciousness, but expressions of consciousness itself. The body is not an independent entity, but a field of awareness within the larger field of pure consciousness or awareness. When one transcends the limited dualistic perception of self and the world and experiences the unity of pure awareness, the sense of time and the aging process can be transcended as well. Because in this state of pure awareness, there is no experience of time as a linear progression, but rather a timeless, eternal being. The Vedic and non-dual traditions thus present a radically different view of the nature of reality, consciousness, and the human body compared to the materialist, dualistic perspectives of Western science. So once again, the Vedic and non-dual traditions thus present a radically different view of the nature of reality, consciousness, and the human body compared to the materialistic, dualistic perspectives of Western science. These traditions offer a rich and nuanced understanding of the nature of consciousness and its relationship to the physical world. So when we experience are timeless, boundless, infinite, irreducible, fundamental, eternal, shapeless, formless, fundamental self. We transcend time. And in that experience, the body becomes ageless. These are the philosophical and scientific reasonings behind the idea of ageless body, timeless mind. More important than anything is for you to have a relationship with your formless self. Because not only does time slow down, not only does time slow down, sometimes stops, but there's also the experience of bliss, the causal body, which recently I have reframed as the quantum body. Let me know what you think, and I'll be glad to share with you. I'm in a retreat right now, experiencing timelessness and also an ageless body.